Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the channel. I am your host, SnowDrift. So, today we are going to be taking the wheels off the RSX. If you guys would have saw in last video, we found out some interesting information. Today, a lot of shops are closed, but I was able to find one that's open, local to me. And so, we are going to be taking the wheels off the RSX. Look, a wild CBR appears. We're going to be taking the wheels off the RSX, and we're going to be taking them and getting them balanced, and hopefully that will take care of our shaking problem, I hope. So I'm going to grab the jack. I'm going to grab the jack stands too, so that means you guys get left behind.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
I have officially turned the RSX into a hover car. Don't mind that. That is sketch city right there, but it's not going to be like this for long. So I got the RSX up on the jack stands and up on the jack because I don't have any other jack stands. Like that's the best I can do. So I'm going to get some more jack stands soon. But I got the rear wheels back there. I got the front wheels in there. So we are headed to the tire shop and we're going to get these babies fixed up nice. All right, so we're here at the tire place. I just checked in, and I'm about to unload the wheels and the tires, and they're gonna get it done for me. All right. They said it's only gonna take about 15 minutes, really. They always say an hour, but guy told me about 15 minutes. So I'm gonna go get some food real quick because it's 11:45 and I have not eaten today. So I'm gonna go do that, gonna throw away some trash, and then we'll come back, pick them up, pay, and we'll go throw them back on the RSX. So but I've been doing all these videos over my Acura, and my stepsister, she got a new car. She got that guy right there. That is I think they said it was a 2010 TSX. It's got a K24 in it, which is kind of cool. Because, you know, you guys know that about me. It's not quite the same engine as what I'm working with, but it's close. Some people may argue that it's not close at all. It's a K24. I mean, come on. So, I'm gonna check it out. I may not film too much, but it's her car, so she's been wanting to show it to me. So I just ate lunch, and I'm gonna check out that, and then we should be able to go pick up those wheels. So let's take a look at this bad boy. Let's go. Well, good news. We got the wheels back. They are balanced, and they said that they balanced just fine. But it seems that I can never catch a break with this car. One of the wheels is bent. And it's bent pretty bad. I'll show you guys that when I go to put them back on the car, which we're about to go do right now. I looked at it and I've seen worse. I have definitely seen worse, but if you ain't got a round wheel, it's definitely gonna lead to some issues. So we might be looking at getting some new wheels, or at least replacing that one. If I can find one that's the same serial number, or the same part number, rather, the same offset, all that crap, we will, I'll probably just grab one of those and when we go to get new tires, because that's probably gonna be the next big thing we do is tires. So, we're gonna get back home, we're gonna throw them on, we're gonna take it for a test drive. Okay, so the wheel in question is this one, and I'm putting it on the back. I don't want to put it on the back, but I have to. They say that if you have a bent rim that, you know, I got it balanced, and they said it rolled pretty good, but putting it on the back because they said that I would notice it less on the rear.
Don't know if that's true or not, but they deal with it every day. So I'm going by their word. So, oh no. That was just my hub centering ring. There we go. They said that this one was bent. So I think the bend is right here. Right there. You guys can kind of see it if you really pay attention. You can kind of see where it's flat right there, which really sucks. I think it's only on the back. Let's look at the front. I mean, I think I can kind of see it in the front a little bit, but since this, it has this spoke here, it's got a lot more strength in the front. So maybe I'm just crazy. Maybe it's just the placebo effect of me knowing that it's bent now. But I'm going to throw it on the car and we're going to go for a ride. And once we get back home, I think I might be doing some wheel shopping, which is kind of a bummer. But who knows? Maybe it's meant to be. We'll see. Okay, so I got the car down off of the jack and jack stands, and I'm torquing all the wheels down. I'm torquing them to about 82 foot-pounds. Most car manufacturers say, you know, between 80 and 84. So I'm doing 82 because I don't really torque my wheels, but I feel like it's a special occasion. So instead of just cranking on them like I normally do, I'm going to torque them and see if I yield any different results. It's more of an experiment than anything else. I've never had any trouble not torquing my wheels, but I feel like I should give it a shot. And I always try and go back and torque the first one that I torque to make sure that it's still good. So I did that. And now I'm just gonna clean everything up and we're gonna take it for a test drive and see how she rolls. Gonna grab some gas real quick. All right, threw some gas in her real quick. Pandora would like to communicate with my phone. Sure, go ahead. We're gonna get out on the interstate because this thing, it really only does it when I'm going a little bit quicker than normal.
Episode. I went to Dad's house and I put some stuff on eBay. He taught me how to do that. I'm going to be putting some car parts on there pretty soon. Well, I've already technically got some car parts on there. I listed a couple things today, and hopefully I'll get some kickback on that. Hopefully someone will be needing what I'm selling, and I'll be able to make some money and maybe put some of that money into the car, you know? So that'd be really cool. I got a lot of real neat stuff just laying around that I can't use anymore because I've either sold the car that it went on or whatever, or it's just not exactly what I want. So I got a few things here and there kicking around, so maybe someone will need it. You know, one man's trash is another man's treasure, as they do say. So, but anywho, sorry that this video didn't really have a whole lot of substance to it. I do apologize for that, but this coming weekend, I got a lot of cool stuff that we're going to be doing, and I can't wait. So it's going to be fun. So, and I've also got another video in the works that I couldn't finish because of reasons. And so I'm going to finish up that video too. So I got a couple more videos coming out pretty soon, you guys. And thanks for the views. I'm really happy with the way that these videos have been turning out here lately. I really do enjoy wrenching on the car and whatnot. But to wrap it up, the balancing did help quite a bit. Not perfect, like I said earlier, but better for sure. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you're not subscribed to the channel yet and you enjoyed the video, please give me a subscribe, give me a like, all that jazz. And make sure you share the video with your friends, your family, and of course your dog. And I hope you all have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.